The first track features a voice above a minimalist but melodic electronic accompaniment. And what a voice. It's flat, wistful, breathy and mesmeric, counting out a cycle of numbers forever, from 1 through to 12, again and again, slow and measured. The 11 in particular is meltingly sensuous beyond belief. An 11, so charged with sensuous voltage, in fact, that it's the perverse climax of the cycle, awaited like the hidden magic midnight on a clock face. 11, soft and so alluring in its shyness of 12, with its assonance of ease like a velvet caress. Up go the tempo and the heat when her second track bubbles in, supplanting the first. The polished control of this track channels so romantic and abandoned the world of the early evening city as to coruscate like champagne. Such heart within its slickness, stepping out in pink and blue in a yellow taxicab. Her third track focuses her oncoming rush from the stage to the sky, where her fingers flick stardust clouds like a video effect till she twinkles over Hollywood high above the hills. Her fourth forges upward further still, culminating in a long solo flight of lead guitar so virtuosic that it streaks like a comet into ecstasy, a starburst of glamour and perfection and passion. For her fifth track, there's nowhere higher up she can go. So she coasts on a level in the stratosphere, effortless, blown like a melancholy rose on the wind, borne along through the sky on a lush flight of red. When her sixth track strolls in, she's coasted down again to a level where she floats among the people of the night. The nightshade has deepened, disembodied voices call around her, whirl and flash of eyes, some warm and others cold. She is held under poisoned skies, stained by the sunset on the city, death behind the beauty of a warm breeze blowing on her face and on the lips she kisses, softest, warmest urban lips. Her seventh is the last track. And though she has descended from her third and fourth and fifth, her attaining those heights left a structure up there where she now can send her notes just by glancing at its girders. And this she does, firing up a track with a march of majestic violins whose sweep and pace cannot be stopped, universally known as it strides around the globe throughout eternity. Jamie stares at the depths in the dark of his screen, as the grandeur and whirl of her music spirals inward through his cells and recedes into distance and silence.